Welcome everybody, my name is Eric Chen, and I'm an applications engineer for Texas Instruments brushless DC motor drivers. Today I will be providing an overview and comparing the various methods of sensorless motor startup for three-phase brushless DC motors. In this video, we'll discuss the advantages and disadvantages of the three main sensorless BLDC motor startup methods: align, slow first cycle, and initial position detection. By the end of this video, we'll understand the trade-offs and reasons for choosing between the different sensorless motor startup methods. In order to achieve reliable motor startup, we need to first know the initial position of the rotor. However, without sensors to tell us the rotor position, we need other ways to determine the initial position of BLDC motor in a sensorless system. There are three primary techniques used to determine the initial position of BLDC motor to achieve reliable sensorless startup. The first is align, also known as align and go, where the system simply applies a fixed current through two of the motor phases. A large enough current and long enough time will force the motor to rotate and align to the vector generated from the energized coils. The second technique is called slow first cycle. This is similar to the align method in that the rotor is forced to a known position using an align vector. However, in this case, a slow and moving rotating align vector is driven for one electrical cycle, and the rotor catches up with the rotating vector at some point along the first cycle. Last but not least is initial position detection, which determines the initial rotor position without moving it by taking advantage of the varying inductance of the three motor phase windings due to the rotor position. Out of the three motor startup techniques discussed in this video, align is the simplest technique and easiest to implement. The system simply applies a static current for a fixed amount of time to force the rotor into alignment with the generated magnetic field. As a result of the alignment, the next step, the acceleration, starts with a fixed known position. However, there are a few drawbacks. The amount of current applied and the duration are dependent on motor characteristics, so the system has to be tuned for each motor. Another downside to align is that the technique can and most likely will result in some backwards rotation before settling to a known position. Backwards rotation is undesirable or often are not allowed in many motor applications. Lastly, there is a small chance that the rotor happens to be 180 degrees out of phase from the align vector, in which case the rotor will fail to align properly. One way to mitigate this potential downside is to use double align and apply two consecutive yet different align vectors to ensure that the rotor will align to at least one of the applied vectors. Of course, the consequence of applying two align vectors is that double align will take twice the time to complete compared to single align. Let's take a look at an animation of the single align technique. The system applies a constant current through two of the motor phases and wait for a certain period of time until the motor has settled into its final position. When align is done, the rotor position is determined and the motor can be accelerated in a forward direction from there. This next animation shows the reason why double align is sometimes used to ensure the reliability of alignment. In the small chance when the rotor position happens to be 180 degrees away from the applied align vector, no matter how long the system applies the align vector, the rotor will not move. Therefore, a second align vector that is 120 degrees apart from the first vector is applied to ensure that the motor ends up settling to a known position. Again, due to the duration of applying two different align vectors, double align will take more time than single align to complete. Slow first cycle is similar to align, except that instead of applying a stationary align vector, the system slowly moves the align vector for one electrical cycle throughout the alignment process. One main advantage of this method is the ability to achieve faster startup, since not only will the motor position be determined, the rotor will already be moving when the system begins acceleration. However, the motor being driven needs to have a low startup torque requirement in order for the rotor to properly catch up with the rotating vector, and the technique still doesn't eliminate the possibility of the motor spinning backwards. This animation demonstrates the basic operation of slow first cycle. When the align vector slowly rotates around in circle, the rotor catches up with the rotating field and remains aligned and moving in sync with the align vector by the end of the first cycle. Next, we'll take a closer look at initial position detection, also known as IPD. It is an algorithm that detects the position of the motor by applying current pulses on each phase and measuring the time interval for the pulse to reach a user set threshold. This is a method used to detect the motor position without moving the rotor, which is a big advantage compared to the previous two methods discussed, since it eliminates the possibility of the motor spinning backwards during motor startup. However, due to its inherent complexity, this method requires additional hardware functionalities such as comparators, timers, and decision logic, so it is more resource-intensive and complex to implement. In addition, variations in motor parameters between different motors means that IPD needs to be tuned for each motor. The type of motor will affect the tuning of the duration and amplitude of current pulses. A lower frequency current pulse is preferable for a motor with lower inductance and higher current amplitude, and vice versa. To understand how IPD works, we need to first understand that the motor winding inductance, or saturation, is dependent on the rotor magnet position. This is because the magnetic field generated by the permanent magnet of the motor can superimpose onto the magnetic field generated by the phase current passing through the motor winding. This principle can be demonstrated in a simple experiment by observing the current rise time in an inductor, with and without a permanent magnet close to the inductor core. As seen in the bottom graphs, with the magnet nearby, the inductor is saturated and the current rises faster after a constant voltage is applied. Also, notice that the stronger the magnet is, the faster the current rises. In short, if the permanent magnet's field is aligned with the phase winding, the inductor is saturated and the phase current rise time will be shorter. Applying this principle to initial position detection, we can see that the top graph on the right shows when the rotor magnet is not aligned with the direction of the phase windings being driven, then the current rise time is longer. Comparing that with the bottom graph, when the rotor magnet is aligned with the phase windings being driven, then the current rise time is shorter. Using the concept of current rise time dependency on the rotor magnet position, the IPD method sequentially applies voltage across two of the three motor phases in all six permutations while monitoring the current rise time. When the current reaches the threshold, the voltage across the motor is stopped, and the system measures the time it takes from when the voltage is applied until the current threshold is reached. The state with the shortest current rise time represents the state with the minimum inductance, and the minimum inductance of a particular driving state indicates that the motor is aligned with that particular energized phase. The system can then proceed with the reliable motor startup using the known initial rotor position. This concludes the video overview on the three primary sensorless startup methods. To find more motor driver technical resources and search products, please visit ti.com/motordrivers. Thank you for watching.